Welcome back. Today I am doing this look here for you. This is a look I did on Instagram a little while ago. It's just like a rose gold kind of glammy look. I don't know what to call it. I'm sure I'll think of something by the time I upload this. It's something I put on Instagram, and I had a few requests from different people on how to do it, how to put it together. So I've done this little tutorial today to show you how I achieved this look. Since it was so long ago that I put on Instagram, I couldn't exactly remember what I did the first time, but it's essentially the same thing. This is a look that I've used for around Christmas time or really nice fancy events, just because it's classic and really flattering for anybody. It's just really nice and simple and not as hard as it seems, I promise you. And I've given some options along the way. So that if you want it to be a little less dramatic, you can have a more daytime version of this. So throughout the tutorial, I kind of mentioned just a few different ways you can do it, and also different levels of intensity. So you could do the daytime version of this, or like a little bit deeper version, or go full glam like this if you're feeling up to it. I'm certainly no professional when it comes to applying makeup. I love makeup, but my technique is still not perfect. So hopefully this video is quality enough for you to at least see what I was doing and to be able to do it yourself, because that's the whole point of these videos. So if you want to see how to put this look together and what I used, then get comfy and keep on watching. Concealer under my eyes. I've settled that with a Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. Filled in my brows using the NYX Tame and Frame and the L'Oreal Brow Artist Kit. And also did a little bit of contour and blush just to add a bit of colour and shape, so my whole base is done, just because this is mostly about the eye look than anything else. So I'm going to start off by prepping my eyelids just using a concealer. Just using the Fit Me, the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer as a base, just to cover up any like veins or discoloration, so that it's a nice even base to work on. Just going to put a little bit of dots on either side, and I'm going to buff that in using a concealer brush. So I'm just going to lightly set that with a translucent powder. This just makes it a lot easier for the shadow to glide over the base. If it's still a bit wet, it might not blend as well. So like I said before, I'm not sure exactly how I did this last time, but it's pretty much the same thing. So I'm going to start with the Morphe 35N palette, which is this one here. It's just a bunch of matte neutral tones. So to start off, we'll be filling in the transition, just picking what shade to use. I'm thinking for the very first shade, I'll use this one here, third across from the top. Just because it's a nice mid-tone, but it's a little bit more warm than these ones over here. And I kind of want this look to be a little bit glowy. So I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that on my brush, on a blending brush. This is the Makeup Geek Soft Dome brush. And I'm just going to dust that into my crease. So what I'm doing here is, this is firstly defining the crease area, particularly on my kind of lids. It tends to get a bit lost. I don't have like a defined crease line like other people do, so I'm just putting it in this area to create a shadow, and also because it's a warmer tone, it'll make the whole look a bit more warm and bright, as opposed to a cool tone, which is a bit more darker. So I'm just going back and forth, blending that out so it's really soft. There's no harsh lines, it's just really soft and smooth. It doesn't really add too much colour or definition, it's just a little bit, just to kind of get things started. So we're going to deepen that up by putting in a slightly darker colour with a smaller brush. So I'm going to take the Makeup Geek Defined Crease Brush, which is is this one here. And what color am I going to use? And I'm going to go in with this brown color here. So this is a bit more cool toned, and it's just going to help define that crease a little bit more and add some more definition. So you can see even the difference there, how this one's just that little bit more defined. You can see that shadow has just helped carve out that crease line. So as I'm doing that, I'm putting it just above my crease, but if you have a defined crease, you can just whack it on in there. And I'm just blending it into the color that we had before. So again, a lot of back and forth, and I'm just keeping it in that arch at this point. I'll be creating an outer corner in this area later on. For now, I'm just deepening that crease. It's really important to make sure that you blend out each step as you go. If you have the attitude of, oh, I'll come back and fix it later, it's a lot harder and tends to be really messy. So if you make sure that each step is completely blended before you move on, you'll have a much more smoother look. So that's the crease work done at this point. I might touch it up later to make it deeper, but it's hard to know without having the other colors how much you're gonna need it. Better to hold back and add more later than to go too far at the start. Now I'm gonna move on to the Lorac Pro palette, which will have the feature color. So it's the Lorac Pro 2 palette, which is more cool toned than the original one. These are the colors here. So the main feature color for this look is gonna be this one. Yeah, this one here called Rosé, which is a really beautiful rose gold color. So that'll be going in the center of the lid. So I'm just gonna take a flat packing brush. So got this flat packing brush here by e.l.f. and I'm going to take that rosé color and just pop it all over that bottom lid, also known as the mobile lid, because it's the part of the lid that moves around. If you find that you're not quite getting the pigmentation you want, or if you want it to pop a little bit brighter, you can use some setting spray on your brush. I'm not gonna bother today because I think this is working just fine. But say if you wanted it for a nighttime look and you really wanted it to bang, then all you'd have to do is put some setting spray on your brush before you put it into the powder. The reason why I'm doing more dabbing motions is because I find if I kind of smear it around, it's not as pigmented. It tends to blend out too much, which means the color isn't quite as dense. So of course, if you really wanted to, you could leave the look at this, where it's just very daytime friendly. It's very natural tones. There's nothing too crazy going on. It's just that little bit of glitter on the lid itself. But for today, I'm going to deepen it up, but it's totally up to you. So I'm going to switch back to the Morphe palette I was using before and get a darker color to further define the outer crease. Choices. So if we take a look at this palette again, I'm going to go in using, I think, this one here because it's a little bit darker, this dark brown, and just start applying that to the outer edges of my eye using a crease brush or a pencil brush, anything that's small. This one is the Zoeva Petite Crease Brush, the number 231. And I'm just gonna pick up that color. Again, best to start with a little bit and slowly build up so you don't make a big mess. So the way I do it for my eye shape is to just dab it in the corner and start to feather it out. So I don't know if you can see that. So I'm just dabbing in the corner and then feathering out along the crease line and along the lid, just that outer third, and feathering it out so that it blends. So you can even see there the difference between leaving it as it was before and then adding that extra dimension in the corner. It just makes it seem a bit more glam and a little bit more defined. Also, I'm starting with the brown just so that there's a bit of a gradient and a build-up. If I went straight in with black, it could be a little bit harsh and wouldn't blend so well. So I'm going to go in with the black after this, but this is just to help it along in the process. I'm actually going to take this colour and blend it down into my lower lash line as well, just to help it tie in the look. It can look a bit top heavy if you just leave all your shadow at the top and don't blend it into your bottom lash line as well. So I'm just going to run that same colour along very lightly and connect it up to the top eyeshadow. So see how it's like one continuous line that goes from the bottom all the way up. That's what you want. And so this way you don't even need to use eyeliner if you don't want to, because that's already defining your lower lash line for you. Okay, so I'm feeling this isn't blended out enough, particularly on this side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back with the first brush I used, which is the big fluffy blending brush. I'm not going to put any more product on it, just whatever's left, which shouldn't be much at all. And just go over the edges there so that it softens out and it's not so harsh. Just very lightly, like I'm not putting any pressure on there at all. And I'm just going to flick out the edges so that it's nice and soft. Same with this side. This side didn't look so bad. This is much more blended, but just going to help it along anyway. And this is, of course, the trick with all eye makeup looks. It's just to apply, blend, apply, blend, apply, blend. Because every time you blend it, it weakens the colour and the intensity. So if you want it to be more intense again, you just have to go back in. And it's just this constant balance of putting on colour, blending it out, so that it's nice and smooth, but also nice and pigmented. So I'm pretty happy with that. Again, you could leave it at this stage. You know, there's a lot of different levels that you could take a makeup look to. This one's definitely more intense than before, but I'm gonna take it one step further and add some black, which is gonna make it way more intense, way more defined, and just take it to that glam level. The trick with using darker colours, if you don't want a massive smoky eye look, is to just use a little bit at a time and make sure you use small brushes. So with this look, I've been starting with a big fluffy brush and each time getting a smaller and smaller brush, so that's only a little bit of products being spread around. So this time going in with the black, I'm using this very tight small pencil brush, or it's actually called the Makeup Geek Outer V brush. But anything that's smaller than all the other brushes you've used, if you're doing like the black, I'm going to go with this one today because I'm a bit more confident with what I'm doing. But if you're not confident, I would start with a really small one and then you can always blend it out with a bigger brush. So I'm just going to use the blackest black out of the Morphe palette, which is this one here, and put that in the really outer V, and also just a little bit in along the tight line of the lashes. So I'm literally like just tapping the tip of the brush into the shadow, so it's only picking up the tiniest amount. And I'm just going to do what I did before with the brown and just start dabbing before I start blending it out. Just slowly building up that colour and running it along the top lash line to make those lashes seem a bit thicker and fuller. Again, just using whatever's left on that brush to connect those top and bottom lash lines. Make sure the look is really smooth. Let's do the other eye. Okay, so I think I'm done with adding black. And I'm just going to blend that out again. So I'll go in with this brush, which is the one I used when doing the darker colour in the crease. And I'm just going to blend along the crease line itself. And also just going to blend those two colours in a little bit better between the black, the brown, and the rose gold. Just that edge there. So, because you don't want just like a harsh line down the middle of your lid. And once again, just because I'm pedantic, I'm going to get that big fluffy blending brush again and go along the very edges of the eye look just to make sure it's completely soft. Okay, so I'm just going to clean up underneath my eyes because there's a little bit of fallout from, you know, bits and pieces as they were being blended. So just by using a powder brush and flicking it all off. Usually that works, just using translucent powder. If this didn't work, then I was just going to get a like cotton pad and just lift up any product that was sitting on top and then just put some more powder on to sweep away any color. That's another tip I should mention here, is that if you find that you have gone too far with the color, if there's like just too much black or it's just too dark and you want to dilute the color a bit, get some translucent powder or a skin colored powder on a fluffy brush and blend it out, and it'll fade the color, the concentration of the color, and help you blend it out a bit more. So I'm actually just going to go in one last time with that rose gold color just to make sure it's completely popping on the lid, because it would have diluted a bit with all the blending around it. So going back in with that flat packing brush and just tapping it on. Easy done. So now I'm going to do some gel liner across the top. You don't need to do this. You can either not do anything at all, just leave it as it is, or you can add some dark shadow just across the line so that that's like your eyeliner. But I find because I intend to use lashes that it's just easier having a gel line there. So I'm just going to quickly do that off camera and come back. Okay, so that's the eyeliner done. Maybe one day I'll feel comfortable doing it on camera, but today is not that day. So as you can see, it's just made it a little bit more crisp. It's helped define that top line. Like I said, you could definitely just use a black eyeshadow, which is a bit softer, but it's all about what intensity you want. So if you want it to be really light, then liner is the way to go. So I'm first just going to put on some mascara. I've just got the Benefit They're Real mascara, and I'm just going to put that on my lashes. Now this is the tricky bit, because you really don't want to be getting dots of mascara on the eye look that you just spent half an hour doing. I mean, it can be fixed, but better to prevent than cure. Also, I just mentioned I didn't bother with a wing liner today, just because I'm actually not a big fan of wing liner. Like, I mean, it's nice, but a lot of the time I just feel like it ruins the look a little bit. It's just not as pretty, I don't think. Like, it's nice and it's sassy and it's defined, but I think softer looks are more feminine, and that's what I like to go for. Just gonna do my lower lash lines as well. You don't have to do this. Yeah, I think it just helps define the eye a little bit more and kind of smoke out that line a bit better. Yeah, so you can see, like, it's not really a big difference. I just find this balances out the whole eye a bit better than not doing it. But totally up to you. Okay. Alright, so I've found a few clumpy bits and they're annoying me, so I'm just going to get a cotton tip and clean up a little bit. Oh no. Oh shoot. Let's feather that out a bit. Okay, so the worst has happened. Mascara has smudged, but it's okay, because if this happens, and it tends to, all you have to do is let it dry. That's most important. If you touch it while it's wet, it will get worse. And then with just a cotton swab, you just off the skin and it should lift. So I'm just gonna let that settle before I wipe it off. Thank goodness it's only a little bit. And just got some on my eyelid here. Trick is not to smear, just like, just dab it a bit. And it should work. It should just lift. Perfect. Okay, so now for eyelashes, I'm going to try to put some false lashes on. It's been a long time, so I may fail. But you certainly don't have to do that. You can leave it the way it is. This looks, you know, fabulous anyway. But just to be a little bit more glam, I'm going to put some lashes on. So I'm going to do that off camera and then come back with some lashes. Okay, lashes went on with great success. Hallelujah. they're still actually setting and drying. They're not quite done yet, so I need to go back in and touch them up a little bit. But while they're doing that, I thought I'd just move on and do the lips. So in the picture that I posted, which this look is based off, I used MAC Russian Red as the main lip colour. So I'm going to do that again today. You can definitely do a nude lip with this because the eyes are pretty full on, but I'm just going to stick to the classic look. Firstly, I'm going to line the lips with a lip liner. I just picked up the wrong one. So I'm going to use the Revlon Colorstay lip liner in red. I love these lip liners. They're not the best, but they're not drying like a lot of other ones, and they're really easy to use. They match nearly every color and they're super cheap. So I have a whole bunch of them. So I'm just going to line my lips first. This helps make the lipstick last longer. Also helps you give a guide as to where you're putting the lipstick, and it also helps with uneven bits on your lips. Like, I know one side of my lips is very different to the other side, so I try to balance it out with a lip liner first. So. Okay, so it's good enough. I find, or at least the way I was taught to do my lips, was always to start at the center of the bottom lip and then draw the edges, and at the top to start with the Cupid's bow, and then I found for myself that it's easier to then connect up from the edges up to the Cupid's bow. I find if I go from the Cupid's bow down, I tend to follow my own lip line, which makes the lips uneven. So if I just kind of stick to the corner and match it up, I find that I get a much more even look in the end. So I'm just going to put on the lipstick, which, as I said, is Russian Red by MAC. It's this really dark, warm red, but you could use any that you like. And of course, with all the makeup products I've used today, all the shadows and the colours, you certainly don't have to use those exact ones. You can just use anything that's similar. It is helpful if you've got a palette that's got a good mix of colours for that reason, but it's up to you what you use. In terms of applying lipstick, again, up to you if you whether you do it straight from the tube or with a brush. If I want a look to be really precise and for something special in particular, I'll use a lip brush just so it's more clean. But today I'm happy just to go in with straight from the tube. I noticed that the edges are just a little bit messy, so I'm just going to go back in with the lip liner and tidy up the edges. So while I'm here, I'm actually just going to touch up with a little bit of highlighter because I didn't put any of that on earlier because it's super easy to go overboard with highlighter, so I wanted to see how bold the rest of the look was first before I bothered going in. So I'm just going to put a touch of that on my cheeks just to take up the look a notch. I'm just using Mary Luminizer by The Balm, which I've been using as my mirror for this whole tutorial. It's beautiful champagne-y gold highlight, which is perfect for this look. Put a bit up here. I'm just going to put a touch on the Cupid's bow. Yeah. Should have done this first, but I will. Right, I'm just going to take a look at my lashes because, like I said before, they weren't quite set, although they seem to have settled fine on their own. I'm just going to pinch them together. It's hard to tell when they're still setting because the glue is, you know, still very white and you're not sure how it's going to go, but like now that the glue is dried, you can't even see it. If you did have any big gloopy bits you wanted to cover up, you can just go in with a very fine brush and some shadow, or use like a liquid eyeliner and just go over the gloopy bits so you've got the smooth black line along the lash line. So there we go, that completes the look. I hope you found this helpful, particularly if you're new to makeup or if you tend to stick to more daytime friendly makeup and not this more bold stuff. It's definitely a big step. It can feel very scary using like lots of colours, lots of dark colours, and it's like, oh, what if it goes messy? I know when I first started trying, I just couldn't get the blending right and I'd have black just all over my eyes, and it was really hard to learn to control myself so that I would have this softer gradient look. So yeah, hopefully the tips that I've popped in there help you. Or maybe this just inspires you for a makeup look you could use for an event coming up or a birthday, anything like that. If you have any questions at all about anything that I've done or any products that I've used, please leave them below and I'll help you out. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time.